Hello, my name is Enon. Welcome back to Undertale. Hopefully I included that first bit with Flowey and then what happens after you beat him. I didn't include the actual fight because I died like 3 times and every time I died it would exit out of the game. And I eventually beat him and it was some fucking shit. If you want to see that fight, definitely look up some other videos of that because it's pretty intense. So now I actually ended up sparing Flowey because I wanted to fuck with him, and sure enough that did. He was like, why would you fucking do that? And, so now I can go back and try to get the true pacifist ending. So I have to backtrack, to Metatons Resort. And I should get a call from Undyne saying that I need to go and do something for her. And I looked in the wiki, and she wants me to deliver a letter to Alphys. And then I should be able to find the true lab. So I'm on my way to do that right now. Gotta take the elevator. Alright. So, gotta backtrack through here. I guess I could just cut to me getting there. I'll do that. Yep, here we go. Getting a call from Undyne. Hey, this is Undyne. Shut up, Iris. This was your idea. Human, you have to deliver something for me. Please? I'm at Snowden in front of Papyrus's. See ya, punk. Alright, so let's do it. So, backtrack through here. And there, the elevator's over here. There's that guy whose name I forgot. Like, I seriously don't remember what his fucking name was, and I don't care. It's left floor one, I believe. Okay. So take the boat to Snowden. Hey, I have something to give you, but you're carrying way too much. Oh, am I? I guess I am. See if there's a box nearby for me to deposit my stuff. I think it's, next to the inn. Let's see, where's the igloo that lets me fast travel? Oh, never mind, I don't need it. Okay, so I'll put my shit in the box. So put the apron in there and the pan in there, and then take that. There we go. So I have a favor to ask you. I need you to deliver this letter to Dr. Alphys. Huh? Why don't I do it myself? Well, it's kind of personal, but we're friends, so I'll tell you. Hotland sucks. I don't want to have to go over there. So here you go. Got Undyne's letter. Oh, and if you read it, I'll kill you. Thanks so much. You're the best. Undyne writes a lot of letters, but she can never seem to find the right words. So when she goes to deliver them herself, she always quits so she can go back and rewrite. That's why she asked you. Because you have no standards. Hey. I guess that's true. I'm a reader fucking letter anyway. What's she gonna do? Unique letter written for Dr. Alphys. What was that? You tried to open the letter, but it's been shut so tightly, you need a chainsaw in order to open it. I see. Okay, go back to Hotland. The boat's a cat thing. Or a dog. I'm not sure what the boat is. Door has no mail slot. Slide the letter under. Why is the door even closed? You slide the letter under the door and give it a knock. Oh. Oh no. Is that another letter? I don't want to open it. Can't I just slide it back out? No. I can't keep doing this. I'll read this one. It shut kind of strongly, isn't it? Wait a second. She actually opened it with a chainsaw. Hey, if this is a joke, it's... Oh my god? Did you write this letter? It wasn't signed, so I had no idea who could have... Oh my god. Oh no. That's adorable. And I had no idea you, wrote that way. It's surprising, too, after all the gross stuff I did. I don't really deserve to be forgiven. Much less, this? And so passionately, too. You know what? Okay, I'll do it. It's the least I can do to make it up to you. Yeah, let's go on a date. Wait, no, that wasn't for me. Dating start? Sorry, I'm still getting dressed. How do I look? My friend helped me pick out this dress. She's got a great sense of, anyway, let's do this thing. Hey, wait. Actually, we still can't start the date yet. Dating stop? I gotta give you items to raise your affection statistic first. That'll increase the chance of a successful outcome for the date, right? Anyway, don't worry, I'm prepared. I've been stockpiling gifts in anticipation for a date like this. First, I've got some metal armor polish. Maybe you can't use that. But I also brought some waterproof cream for your scales. Well, how about this magical spear repair kit that I, hey, let's forget about the items. Let's just start the date. Dating, start. Yeah, let's, date. Do you like anime? Yeah, I do. Hey, me too. Hey, let's go somewhere. But where's a good place to go on a date? I've got it. Let's go to the garbage dump. But why? Here we are. This is where Undyne and I come all the time. We find all sorts of great stuff here. Heh, she really... Oh no. That's her over there. I can't let her see me on a date with you. Why? Because, well... Oh no, here she comes. Hey, there you are. I, realized if you deliver that thing, it might be a bad idea. So I'm gonna do it. Give it to me. Huh? You don't have it? Have you at least seen her? Yes. Yes. So she's somewhere around here. Thanks. I'll keep looking. Oh my god. Well, I guess it's obvious, huh? I really like her. I mean, more than I like other people. I'm sorry. I just figured, you know, it'd be fun to go on, like, a cute kind of pretend date with you? To make you feel better? Well, it sounds even worse when I put it like that. I'm sorry, I messed up again. Undyne's the person I, really want to go on a date with. But I mean, she's way out of my league. Not that you aren't, cool. But Undyne, she's so confident and strong and funny. And I'm just a nobody, a fraud. I'm the royal scientist, but all I've ever done is hurt people. I've told her so many lies, she thinks I'm a lot cooler than I actually am. If she gets close to me, she'll find out the truth about me. What should I do? Tell her the truth, man. The truth. But if I tell her that, she'll hate me. Isn't it better this way? To live a lie where both people are happy? Or a truth where neither of us are? They say be yourself, but I don't really like who myself is. I'd rather just be whatever makes people like me. No, you're right. Every day I'm scared. Scared what will happen if people learn the truth on their own. They'll all get hurt because of me. But how can I tell Undyne the truth? I don't have the confidence. I'm going to mess it up. How can I practice? Obviously, let's roleplay. Roleplay. That actually sounds kind of fun. Okay, which one of us will be Undyne? I guess me. Oh, right. Obviously. Ahem. Hi, Undyne. How are you doing tonight? Oh, man. Yes. thanks. You say that to me a lot, and I never know what to say. But I know you just mean it platonically because we're just friends. So I'd like to talk to you about something. You know what? Fuck it. What? And I would never, I kiss her back, softly. I look gently into her eyes. I start hollering. Undyne, I love you. Undyne. What did you just say? Undyne, I was just, hey, whoa, wait a second. Your outfit's really cute. What's the occasion? Wait a second. Are you two on a date? Yes? I mean, we were, but, I mean, actually, we were only romantically role-playing as you. What? I mean, Undyne, I've been lying to you. What? About what? About, well, everything. I told you that seaweed was, like, scientifically important. Really, I just use it to make ice cream. And those human history books I keep reading, those are just dorky comic books. And history movies, those are just, anime. They aren't real. And that time I told you I was busy with work on the phone, I was just eating frozen yogurt in my pajamas. That time I just wanted to impress you. I just wanted you to think I was smart and cool. That I wasn't some nerdy loser. Alphys. Undyne, I really think you're neat, okay? Alphys. Shh. You just got dunked, nerd! Alphys, I think you're neat, too, I guess. But you've got to realize, most of what you said really doesn't matter to me. I don't care if you're watching kid cartoons or reading history books. To me, all that stuff is just nerdy crap. What I like about you is that you're passionate. You're analytical. It doesn't matter what it is. You care about it. 100%, at maximum power. So, you don't have to lie to me. I don't want you to have to lie to anyone anymore. Alphys, I want to help you become happy with who you are. And I know just the training you need to do that. Undyne, you're going to train me? Pfft, what? Me? Oh, man. Nah, I'm going to get Papyrus to do it. Get those bones shaking. It's time to jog 100 laps, hooting about how great we are. Ready? I'm about to start the timer. Undyne, I'll do my best. There they go. Oh my god. She was kidding, right? Those cartoons, those comics, those are still real, right? Anime's real, right? Anime is totally real. I knew it. The gigantic swords, magical princesses, here I come. Thanks for taking care of Alphys. I didn't get to say what I wanted to, but if things seem like they're going to get better for her, well, I gotta go catch up with them. Later. Wait a minute. How the fuck did I get here? This is so far from everything. Well, I guess I'm saving. Partaking in worthless garbage fills you with determination. Okay, so now I gotta get back to Alphys' lab, I think. Oh. Howdy. If it isn't my good friend, who trusts me? This is Papyrus, your also mutual friend. Alphys and I finished our training early. Very early. So I sent her home. Very home. Now, I feel strongly and for no apparent reason, you should also go there, to her lab house. I have only good feelings about this. Goodbye. Man, I fucking love Papyrus. Anyway. Calming tranquility, you're filled with determination. Okay. I'm so far away from fucking everything, though. I think I can get the key to that house from somebody. Okay. Here's the boat. The boat's over here. Gotta go back to the hot land. Okay. So now I should be able to go in. That's a note. It's a note from Alphys. Read it? It's hard to read because of the handwriting, but you try your best. Hey, thanks for your help back there. You guys, your support really means a lot to me, but as difficult as it is to say this, you guys alone can't magically make my own problems go away. I want to be a better person. I don't want to be afraid anymore. And for that to happen, I have to be able to face my own mistakes. I'm going to start doing that now. I want to be clear. This isn't anyone else's problem but mine. But if you don't ever hear from me again, if you want to know the truth, enter the door to the north of this note. You all at least deserve to know what I did. That's all she wrote. But I thought this was the bathroom. It's an elevator, apparently. What is my fucking microphone doing? Warning, warning. What is going on? Elevator losing power. M tether stability lost. Altitude dropping. No. Oh no. What just happened? Entry number one. This is it. Time to do what the king has asked me to do. I will create the power to free us all. I will unleash the power of the soul. Entry 2. The barrier is locked by soul power. Unfortunately, this power cannot be recreated artificially. Soul power can only be derived from what was once living, so to create more, we will have to use what we have now, the souls of monsters. Entry number 3. But extracting a soul from a living monster would require incredible power. Besides being impractical, doing so would instantly destroy the soul's host. And unlike the persistent souls of humans, the souls of most monsters disappear immediately upon death. If only I could make a monster soul last. Entry 5. I've done it. Using the blueprints, I've extracted it from the human souls. I believe this is what gives their souls the strength to persist after death. The will to keep living, the resolve to change fate. Let's call this power determination. It's a fake plant. Buy chips for 25G? Nah. There's a note on the ground. You can't make it all out. Elevator lost power, enter the center door. That's all you could read. Power room. Okay, I guess I'm not going through the other doors. I can't seem to go in here. What's over here, maybe? Entry 6. Asgore asked everyone outside the city for monsters that had fallen down. Their bodies came in today. They're still comatose, and soon they'll all turn into dust. But what happens if I inject determination into them? If their souls persist after they perish, then freedom might be closer than we all thought. Entry 9. Things aren't going well. None of the bodies have turned into dust, so I can't get the souls. I told the families that I would give them the dust back for the funerals. People are starting to ask me what's happening. What do I do? It's some kind of operating table? It's sticky. You turned on the sink. Okay, it's just a sink, I guess. There's a note on the ground. Can't make it all out. Drain, dropped it, and that's all you could read. Some kind of switch. There's a red-colored slot in the center. What? What the fuck? What the fuck is that? It doesn't have a name? No data available. nobody came. Enemy put a piece of itself into your inventory. What does that do? You take out your cell phone. You can hear voices through the receiver. Come join the fun? What do I do about these guys? I don't want to... Do I hurt them? I don't want to. Memory head. Oh well. Did that first one disappear? Seems like it doesn't care anymore. There's a red key. Took it and put it in your keychain. Red key fits perfectly into the slot. That's fucking weird. Okay, I'm gonna save. I still can't do anything there. Oh, this door opened. Entry 12. Nothing is happening. I don't know what to do. I'll just keep injecting everything with determination. I want this to work. Entry 13. One of the bodies opened its eyes. It's an empty dog food bowl. Seems like a comfortable bed. To bed. You know what? I'm gonna lie on the bed for a bit. What? What is that? What is that? Okay. Does anything happen if I keep laying here? No. Okay, that was fucking weird. Whatever. Something under the sheets. It's a yellow key. Entry 14. Everyone that had fallen down has woken up. They're all walking around and talking like nothing is wrong. I thought they were goners. Clock is broken. Golden flowers. Entry 7. We'll need a vessel to wield the monster souls when the time comes. After all, a monster cannot absorb the souls of other monsters, just as a human cannot absorb a human soul. So then, what about something that's neither human nor monster? Entry 10. Experiments on the vessel are a failure. It doesn't seem to be any different from the control cases. Whatever, they're a hassle to work with anyway. The seeds just stick to you, and won't let go. What the fuck are these things? It did something mysterious. It recognizes it has more to learn from this world. he just got swarmed by butterflies. Hum a familiar tune, but no one heard you. Wash your hands. Nothing happened. It's getting weird. You kneel and pray for safety. Remembers his conscience. I can't spare it, and I can't run away. Pick on Reaperbird. Reaperbird seems to remember something. Someone finally gets it. Shit! Let me try again, I guess. Reaperbird seemed to remember something. What an odd thing. There's a note on the ground. Can't make it all out. Cold. That's all you could read. Some kind of switch. There's a blue-colored slot in the center. I don't have anything blue, unfortunately. Tree 15. It seems like this research was a dead end, but at least we got a happy ending out of it. I sent the souls in the vessel back to Asgore, and I called all the families and told them everyone's alive. I'll send everyone back tomorrow. Wait, what's the other way, though? I think I like this room. Tree 11. Now that Metaton's made it big, he never talks to me anymore, except to ask when I'm going to finish his body. But I'm afraid if I finish his body, he won't need me anymore. Then we'll never be friends ever again. Not to mention, every time I try to work on it, I just get really sweaty. There's a lot of fans. Here's a switch. It's the Amalgamate? Amalgamate is too far away to pet. You just pet the air. Call the Amalgamate. It bounds towards you, flecking a strange liquid from an orifice. Calm down. You pet the amalgamate. It convulses rapidly, then calms down. Rest quietly on your lap for a moment. Suddenly, it shoots away and crawls wildly on the walls. Amalgamate is striking the wall with his claws. This music is fucking weird. Kind of unsettling. Throw your weapon into the corner of the room. The amalgamate brings it back to you. Proudly? You repeat this process a few times. Now Amalgamate is very tired. It leans its dripping, amorphous body on you. Fucking... Pet the amalgamate. It starts to generate a stage one happiness froth. It's just me, or is this getting faster? Amalgamate's convulsions intensify. Pet decisively. The amalgamate seems to be satisfied by all this. Adogeny is contented. You won? What a weird thing. Okay, I'm gonna go save and heal. Okay, so I read that one. Entry 16. No. What about no? What the fuck? Oh. It's a green key. Empty bathtub. That's fucking weird, man. What is that? That's not a save. How could you? Smells like sweet lemons. Lemon bread. You called for help, but nobody came? Welcome to my special hell. Stop trying to eat me. You screamed out, but nobody came. Stop it, you fucker. Red's body shakes. Do you think I'm pretty? Nobody came. Cried as loud as he could, but nobody came. I felt this before. Could this be goodbye? DT extraction machine, status inactive. There's a VHS player with a few tapes picked out beside it. Seemed to be labeled in a specific order. Cancel. The yellow key fits perfectly into the slot. There's a note on the ground. You can't make it all out. Under sheets. That's all you could read. Bunch of VHSs. Seems like it's mostly cartoons of some kind. Entry 4. I've been researching humans to see if I can find any info about their souls. Ended up snooping around the castle and found these weird tapes. I don't feel like Asgore's watched them. I don't think he should. Alright, I'll watch some of them. Psst, Gory, wake up. What is it, dear? And why do you have that video camera? Shush, I want to get your reaction. Gory, dearest, what is my favorite vegetable? Carrots, right? No, my favorite vegetable is edamame. Get it? Go back to bed, dear. No, not yet. Now, if I were a dog, what breed of dog would I be? I don't know. Honey, what kind of dog would you be? I would be a Pomeranian. You sure are excited to have this child. You know, if you keep making jokes like this, one day you could be a famous Pomeranian. Well, I'm going to bed. Hey, come on, Tori. That one was funny. I know. I'm just teasing you. Good night, dear. Good night. Oh, dear. Perhaps it is too dark in here for the video to come out. Okay, let's look at the second one. Okay, Xenon, are you ready? Do your creepy face. Ah. Oh, wait. I had the lens cap on. What? You're not gonna do it again? Come on, quit tricking me. But I thought Xenon was me. I guess not. Oh, wait. I think I saw this on the wiki. When you're naming your character at the beginning, you're not actually naming Frisk. You're naming the first fallen child. Though, I don't know at what point you find out that the character you're playing is actually named Frisk. I don't think it was in that cutscene that I saw earlier, like, way at the beginning of this. No, it wasn't. So I don't know at what point you find out. Whatever. Howdy, Xenon. Smile for the camera. This time I got you. I left the cap on purpose. Now you're smiling for no reason. What? Oh, yeah, I remember. When we tried to make butterscotch pie for Dad, right? The recipe asked for cups of butter, but we accidentally put in buttercups instead. Yeah, those flowers got him really sick. I felt so bad. We made Mom really upset. I should have laughed it off like you did. Anyway, where are you going with this? Huh? Turn off the camera. Okay. I don't like this idea, Xenon. What? No, I'm not. Big kids don't cry. Yeah, you're right. No, I'd never doubt you. Never. Yeah, well, be strong. We'll be strong for everyone. We'll free everyone. I'll go get the flowers. I might have misread some stuff there. Let's see what this last tape is. Xenon, can you hear me? We want you to wake up. You have to stay determined. You can't give up. You are the future of humans and monsters. Psst, please wake up. I don't like this plan anymore. I said I never doubt you. Six, right? We just have to get six. And we'll do it together, right? I don't know what that was about. Entry 19. The families keep calling me to ask when everyone is coming home. What am I supposed to say? I don't even answer the phone anymore. It's a refrigerator. It's empty. I saw that. Seems to contain samples of some kind. I'll get to you in a minute. Asgore left me 5 messages today. 4 about everyone being angry, 1 about this cute teacup he found that looks like me. Thanks, Asgore. It's refrigerator. It's empty. But is it, though? Entry 21. I spend all my time at the garbage dump now. It's my element. It seems to contain samples of some kind. Oh no. Wait, are all of these amalgamates supposed to look like something? Told a bad pun about snow. Her expression starts to shift. You laugh, and keep laughing. It's so funny, you can't stop. Tears run down your face. What? You didn't do that. Told a bad pun about snow. Expression changes more. She's completely calmed down. You won? Green key fits perfectly into the slot. So all those notes in these rooms are just hints on how to find the other things, which... Why does this keep shaking? Fucking... My controller's doing that thing again. Fucking... Can you not? Okay, so now I have to go all the way back. I think it was through here. Yep. Okay, so I think that was all the keys. So now I guess I should be able to go into that door at the beginning. Nope. I saw that. Was all the keys, so I'm gonna save here. I'm going in the door. Here we go. Is it an elevator or not? Wait a minute. What does this do? Seems like another elevator has lost its power. Seems to be turned off. What is this? Seems like this controls the elevator's power. What the fuck? Hey, stop. I got you guys some food, okay? Sorry about that. They get kind of sassy when they don't get fed on time. Anyway, the power went out, and I've been trying to turn it back on, but it seems like you were one step ahead of me. This is probably just a big inconvenience for you, but I appreciate that you came here to back me up. As I said, I was afraid I might not come back. But that's not because of these guys or anything. I was just worried I would be too afraid to tell the truth, that I might run away or do something cowardly. I suppose I owe you an explanation. As you probably know, Asgore asked me to study the nature of souls. During my research, I isolated a power called determination. I injected it into dying monsters so their souls would last after death, but the experiment failed. You see, unlike humans, monsters' bodies don't have enough physical matter to take those concentrations of determination. Their bodies started to melt and lost what physicality they had. Pretty soon, all the test subjects had melted together into... those. seeing them like this, I knew I couldn't tell their families about it. I couldn't tell anyone about it, no matter how much everyone was asking me. And I was too afraid to do any more work, knowing everything I'd done so far had been such a horrific failure. Keep fucking yawning. But now I've changed my mind about all this. I'm going to tell everyone what I've done. It's going to be hard, being honest, believing in myself. I'm sure there will be times where I'll struggle. I'm sure there will be times when I screw up again. But knowing deep down that I have friends to fall back on, I know it'll be a lot easier to stand on my own. Thank you. Come on, guys. It's time for everyone to go home. So, what was the point of all this? Am I done here? It's a smiley. But that's kind of creepy. Ring, it's a voice you have never heard before. Xenon, are you there? It's been a long time, hasn't it? But you've done well. Thanks to you, everything has fallen into place. See you soon. What? What? What the fuck? I've been teleported back to... Oh. Okay. Oh, I don't have to unlock the thing again. So, I guess I have to fight Asgore again. But I read the wiki, and now that I've actually done everything to satisfy the true pacifist ending, something different's gonna happen during the fight. Okay, that's the elevator to go back, which I couldn't use for whatever reason. Doesn't look like Sans is gonna talk to me again. Okay. There's no save point here. So, wait. Hold on, let me check something. Let me check the room where all the souls were down here. Or the coffins or whatever. Yeah, they're still here. Coffin, there's a name engraved on it. It's me. It's empty. Okay. So those are still the same. Okay. Guess we're doing this. Oh, back so soon. I'm ready. Strange light fills the room. Twilight is shining through the barrier. Seems your journey is finally over. You're filled with determination. Human, it was nice to meet you. Goodbye. Desitorial. What a miserable creature torturing such a poor innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. It is I, Toriel, your friend and guardian. At first, I thought I would let you make your journey alone, but I could not stop worrying about you. Your adventure must have been so treacherous, and ultimately, it would burden you with a horrible choice. To leave this place, you would have to take the life of another person. You would have to defeat Asgore. However, I realized I cannot allow that. It's not right to sacrifice someone simply to let someone leave here. Is that not what I've been trying to prevent this whole time? So, for now, let us suspend this battle. As terrible as Asgore is, he deserves mercy, too. Tori, you came back. Do not Tori me, dreamer. You pathetic whelp. If you really wanted to free our kind, you could have gone through the barrier after you got one soul. Taken 6 souls from the humans, then come back and freed everyone peacefully. But instead, you made everyone live in despair, because you would rather wait here, meekly hoping another human never comes. Tori, you're right. I'm a miserable creature. But do you think we can at least be friends again? No, Asgore. Nah, Asgore, human. Nobody fight each other. Everyone's gonna make friends. Or else I'll... Hello, I'm Toriel. Are you the human's friend? It's nice to meet you. Yeah. Nice to meet you. Hey, Asgore, is that your ex? Jeez, that's rough, buddy. Hey. Nobody hurt each other. Oh, are you another friend? I'm Toriel, hello. Hi. There's 2 of them. Hey, nobody fight anyone. If anyone fights anyone, then I'll be forced to ask Undyne for help. Hello. Oh, hello, your majesty. Psst, hey, human. Did Asgore shave and clone himself? Hey guys, what's up? That voice. Hello, I think we may know each other? Oh, hey, I recognize your voice too. I'm Toriel. So nice to meet you. The name's Sans. And, same. Oh, wait, then... This must be your brother, Papyrus. Greetings, Papyrus. It's so nice to finally meet you. Your brother has told me so much about you. Wowee. I can't believe Asgore's clone knows who I am. This is the best day of my life. Hey, Papyrus, what does the skeleton tile his roof with? No proof roof tiles? No, silly. A skeleton tiles his roof with shingles. I changed my mind. This is the worst day of my life. Come on, Asgore. It's gonna be okay. There are plenty of fish in the sea. Yeah, Asgore. Undyne's totally right about that fish thing. Sometimes you just gotta, stop going after furry boss monsters and, just get to know a really cute fish. It's a metaphor. Well, I think it's a good analogy. Oh my god. Will you two just smooch already? The audience is dying for some romantic action. Hey, shut up. Man, the nerve of that guy. Right, Alphys? Alphys? No, he's right. Let's do it. Well, I guess if you want to, then don't hold anything back. Wait, not in front of the human. Right, sorry, I got a little carried away there. My child, it seems as if you must stay here for a while, but looking at all the great friends you've made, I think you'll be happy here. Hey, that reminds me. Papyrus, you called everyone here, right? Well, besides, her. Anyway, if I got here before you, how did you know how to call everybody? Let's just say, a tiny flower helped me. A tiny flower? Oh no. You idiots. While you guys were having your little powwow, I took the human souls. And now, not only are those under my power, but all of your friend souls are gonna be mine too. And you know what the best part is? It's all your fault. It's all because you made them love you. All the time you spent listening to them, encouraging them, caring about them. Without that, they wouldn't have come here. And now, with their souls and the humans together, I will achieve my real form. Huh? Why am I still doing this? Don't you get it? This is all just a game. If you leave the underground satisfied, you'll win the game. If you win, you won't want to play with me anymore. And what would I do then? But this game between us will never end. I'll hold victory in front of you, just within your reach, and then tear it away just before you grasp it, over and over and over. Listen, if you do defeat me, I'll give you your happy ending. I'll bring your friends back, I'll destroy the barrier, everyone will finally be satisfied, but that won't happen. You, I'll keep you here no matter what. Even if it means killing you a million times. That's a million. What? Do not be afraid, my child. No matter what happens, we will always be there to protect you. That's right, human. You can win. Just do what I would do. Believe in you. Hey, human, if you got past me, you can do anything. So don't worry. We're with you all the way. Huh? You haven't beaten this guy yet. Come on, this weirdo's got nothing on you. Technically, it's impossible for you to beat him. But somehow, I know you can do it. Human, for the future of humans and monsters, you have to stay determined. Oh man, it's all those other guys. No, unbelievable. This can't be happening. You. I can't believe. You're all so stupid. All of your souls are mine. What? Who that is? Finally, I was so tired of being a flower. Howdy. Are you there? It's me, your best friend. Asriel. You held on to your hopes. You reduced how much damage you'll take this turn. Oh man, I wasn't expecting to do another boss fight at the end. Think about why you're here now. You can feel the empty space in your inventory getting smaller and smaller. True final battle is finally beginning. Oh, man. You know, I don't care about destroying this world anymore. Total control over the timeline. I just want to reset everything. What? But it refused. I can't die? I don't know what to do about this. This episode's been going on way too long. I need to look up the thing real quick. Thank you. I think I have to fight him. Like, actually fight him? I missed. Fucking that lightning attack, though. Shit! This fight, though. All your progress, everyone's memories, bring them all back to zero. And then we can do everything all over again. Chaos Buster. You know what the best part of all this is? You'll do it. And then you'll lose to me again. Again. Fucking. His attacks do so much fucking damage, it's ridiculous. Galactica blazing. Oh, it's the star thing. Oh, geez. Fucking A. It seems like I'm not really losing progress in this battle. Like, I'm not dying, so I mean... I'm not technically dying. The power that let you get this far, it's gonna be your downfall. My man, I gotta stay determined. Now, enough messing around. It's time to purge this timeline once and for all. What the hell? Wait, what did you do? Even after that attack, you're still standing in my way? Wow, you really are something special. But don't get cocky. Up until now, I've only been using a fraction of my real power. Let's see what good your determination is against this. Oh. Okay, so you got some fucking wings. Also, now I can't use my fucking items. Can't move your body. That didn't kill me. Every time you die, your grip on this world slips away. Every time you die, your friends forget you a little more. Life will end here in a world where no one remembers you. I can't use items here. Gotta save Undyne. Shit. I also gotta save Toriel. And of course I gotta save Alphys. That's everyone. Someone else. Strangely, as your friends remembered you, something else began resonating within the soul. Stronger and stronger. It seems that there's still one less person that needs to be saved. But who? Suddenly, you realize. You reach out and call their name. Huh? What are you doing? What did you do? What's this feeling? What's happening to me? No. I don't need anyone. No, I gotta save you too, man. Quit shooting laser beams at me. You need to chill. Oh, he's getting slower and slower now. Xenon, do you know why I'm doing this? Why I keep fighting to keep you around? I'm doing this because you're special. You're the only one that understands me. You're the only one who's any fun to play with anymore. No, that's not just it. I'm doing this because I care about you. I care about you more than anybody else. I'm not ready for this to end. I'm not ready for you to leave. I'm not ready to say goodbye to someone like you again. So, please, stop doing this, and just let me win. I'm so alone. I'm so afraid. I'm so sorry. I always was a crybaby, wasn't I? I know. You're not actually Xenon, are you? He's been gone for a long time. What is your name? Frisk? That's a nice name. Frisk. I haven't felt like this for a long time. As a flower, I was soulless. I lacked the power to love other people. However, with everyone's souls inside me, I not only have my own compassion back, but I can feel every other monster's as well. They all care about each other so much, and they care about you too, Frisk. I wish I could tell you how everyone feels about you. Papyrus, Sans, Undyne, Alphys, Toriel. Monsters are weird. Even though they barely know you, it feels like they all really love you. Frisk, I understand if you can't forgive me. I understand if you hate me. I acted so strange and horrible. I hurt you. I hurt so many people. Friends, family, bystanders. There's no excuse for what I've done. It's okay, man. What? Triss, come on. You're gonna make me cry again. Besides, even if you do forgive me, I can't keep those souls inside of me. The least I can do is return them. But first, there's something I have to do. Right now, I can feel everyone's hearts beating as one. They're all burning with the same desire. With everyone's power, with everyone's determination, it's time for monsters to finally go free. What are you doing? The barrier was destroyed. Frisk, I have to go now. Without the power of everyone's souls, I can't keep maintaining this form. In a little while, I'll turn back into a flower. I'll stop being myself. I'll stop being able to feel love again. So, Frisk, it's best if you just forget about me, okay? Just go be with the people who love you. I don't want to let go. Frisk, you're going to do a great job, okay? No matter what you do, everyone will be there for you, okay? Well, my time's running out. Goodbye. By the way, Frisk, take care of Mom and Dad for me, okay? Oh, man. This is all just a bad dream. Please wake up. Oh, you're awake. Thank goodness. We were so worried. It felt like you were out forever. Yeah, any longer and I would have freaked out. Tell us next time you decide to take a nap, okay? Yeah, you made Papyrus cry like a baby. What? I didn't cry. I don't cry. I just caught something in my eye. What did you catch? Tears. Now. The important part is that Frisk is alright. Here, Frisk. Why not drink some tea? It'll make you feel better. How about we give them space first? They must be very exhausted. Though, from what I'm not certain. Frisk, we don't remember exactly what happened. There was a flower, and then everything went white. But now the barrier is gone. When you're ready, we'll all return to the surface. It seems the door to the east will lead us there now. But before then, perhaps you might want to take a walk? You can say goodbye to all your wonderful friends. Do as you wish. We'll all wait for you here. Oh, man. Hello, Frisk. Office upgraded my phone. Having a lot of fun with the texting feature. Sans, check out this one. Oh, man. Tori, that's brutal. I can't believe the Queen has returned. And also that she's a huge dork. You two are 2 feet away from each other. Why are you texting? Worry not, Papyrus. We're texting for a good reason. Why is that? Well, because we're huge dorks. Sans, please do not say that. You're not a dork. You're more of a bonehead. Wow, those puns are even less funny coming from her. Then why are you smiling? It's a pity smile. Frisk, Tori was telling me how she made butterscotch pie for you. Oh, I should bake it for everyone sometime. Oh, that sounds really good. Cooking? Can I help? Wait a second. Can I help too? Certainly. It would be fun to cook together. On second thought, maybe I'll order a pizza. So, Asgore, how about making me a member of the Royal Guard? Well, Papyrus, now that the war is over, we might not need the Royal Guard anymore. What? Then what was the point of the human's quest? They journeyed all that way, and I'm still not a member of the Royal Guard? Truly, this is the worst possible ending. So, Alphys, what do you want to do now that we're all free? We have the whole world to explore now. Well, of course I'm going to go out and... No, I should be honest. I'm going to stay inside and watch anime like a total loser. That's the spirit. Everyone, a celebration to being losers! Heh, Papyrus has the right idea. Losing to Frisk is the best thing to ever happen to me. So I'm glad that we... Huh? What is it, Asgore? What's anime? Oh my god? Frisk, please, help me explain what anime is to Asgore. You see, it's like a cartoon, but... with swords? So it's like a cartoon, but with swords. Golly, that sounds neato. Where is this? Where can I see the anime? Hold on, I think I have some on my phone. Here, look at this! Never mind. Golly, were those two robots kissing? Boy, technology sure is something, isn't it? Yeah, it sure is. Psst, Frisk, you've got to tell me. Do you think Asgore and Toriel are, ever gonna get back together? Maybe. Yeah. That's what I hope, too. Just think about how cute they must have been together. It's quickly becoming my number one ship of all time. Tori and Ori. My old boss and his ex-wife. That sounds a lot less cool all of a sudden. Howdy, Frisk. Sorry about almost trying to take your soul. I feel very bad about it. I hope we can still be pals? Hey, don't worry about it, Asgore. I think everybody's tried to kill Frisk at least once. Oh, I see. In that case, I'm not sorry, Frisk. Asgore, that's not what I meant. Well, I guess I'm done here. Might as well go to the barrier. So I'm gonna save. And let's go. If you leave here, your adventure will really be over. Your friends will follow you out of the underground. I'm ready. Oh my. Isn't it beautiful? Everyone? Wow. it's even better than on TV. Way better. Better than I ever imagined. Frisk, you live with this? The sunlight's so nice, and the air is so fresh. I really feel alive. Hey, Sans, what's that giant ball? We call that the sun, my friend. That's the sun? Wowee, I can't believe I'm finally meeting the sun. I could stand here and watch this for hours. Yes, it is beautiful, is it not? But we should really think about what comes next. Oh, right. Everyone, this is the beginning of a bright new future. An era of peace between humans and monsters. Frisk, I have something to ask of you. Will you act as our ambassador to the humans?
Yeah.
Yeah, Frisk will be the best ambassador, and I, the Great Papyrus, will be the best mascot. I'll go make a good first impression. Well, someone's gotta keep him from getting into trouble. See you guys. But you're going the wrong way. Man, do I have to do everything? Papyrus, wait! Hey, Undyne, wait up. Whoops. Should I do something? Well, gotta go. It seems that everyone is quite eager to set off. Frisk, you came from this world, right? So you must have a place to return to, do you not? What will you do now? What? Frisk, you really are a funny child. If you had said that earlier, none of this would have happened. It's a good thing you took so long to change your mind. Well, I suppose, if you really do not have any other place to go, I will do my best to take care of you for as long as you need. All right? Now, come along. Everyone's waiting for us. Oh man, I actually finally beat the fucking game. I had to fight a fucking Photoshop flower. Well, there we go. I did the true pacifist run. Next, I'll do the bad time. I'm ready to have a bad time now. Anyway, I guess watch the rest of this cutscene. Or credits. Watch the rest of the credits.